It's Monday, Sunday, June 2nd, our last day in Vienna. We're headed to St. Stephen's Cathedral. It's a little rainy, but it looks like it's going to clear up. Escada Hermes, Patricia found her shopping area. Quite elaborate. Berlitz Language Center. She's getting pretty good at German. She's taking to it quite handily. Land of Mozart, not Handel, she says.
If it was a nice day.
Yeah.
Everything would be full.
Cafe's all set up, but no customers in the rain. Well, they have to put up their umbrellas. There's one right there. Time for a coffee, you think?
I think we should do the cathedral and then coffee.
All right.
I don't think the cathedral takes more than an hour.
Yeah. Keep track. Yeah, so we're in St. Stephen's Cathedral. And it's all like lit up and decorated. They have these colored lights, it's incredible. Get a good exposure on this. Yes. Save our sorry souls. Say she's got a glass of wine in the church. You want to go over and light a candle? Fight for your candle spot around here. Here's some what's used. Pick a spot. Yeah, in trouble. You got it. Joining of the candles.
Save our sorry souls.
Save our sorry souls. Is it going to make it?
There we go. Okay, we're good. Don't forget to pay.
Oh, yeah, I got to pay. It doesn't count. That's a pretty clever idea with the lights, don't you think? Yeah. Okay. Okay, we're at the what?
Cafe Diglas, another of the classic Viennese coffee houses. This is the house torte, the Cafe Diglas torte.
Torte?
Torte. This is a bread pudding.
Bread pudding, yes.
And our
usual lattes. Nice little spot by the window. We're in the Art History Museum.
Sort of like the National Gallery.
Yeah, it's like the National Gallery. It's quite impressive. This is Vienna, I'll tell you. We're going to go into an exhibition called Buntgatte. It's the way the Roman statues originally looked. The Greek and the Romans, where they actually painted the statues instead of being totally white. Now, if we could figure out how to get in.
Nice
Pretty garish colors. Here's how you see it today, but here's how it looked. On the original statues. This is how it looks now, and here's how they originally looked. Wow, look at that gold work. It's flesh colored. They painted the stone to flesh color. See these small aperture phone cameras, everything is in focus. It's got a very wide depth of field. It's kind of cool. You don't have to focus. Amazing pieces.
These are different kinds of stones that they carve.
They carve these? Carved stone. This museum is quite incredible. We have the model of the Acropolis. Yeah, that ceiling is unbelievable. They have these special lights here that kind of interferes with the video. I guess it's to keep the UVs down or something, so it doesn't affect the work. This is your dressing
razors,
implements. A tea service. And then a port going there. Okay. How's this for a tea room? Jane Seymour, third wife of Henry VIII. This was by the court painter, Hans Holbern. Holbein. The court painter of Henry VIII. Okay. These rooms are incredible. Totally enormous. Gigantic paintings. This is a Rubens. It's too big to, Well, yeah, most of this room is Rubens. It's just too big to even. I know. The detail in these paintings are incredible. Rubenesque. It's unreal. Painting's way too big to capture. Can't get the resolution either that you need. I like to get closer, but they have an alarm system here. You can't get too close to them. Show you some of this detail. there's a story going on here in each one of these paintings. But we don't have really any time to read it all. Because it closes in about an hour and there's too many things to see. Yeah, these are like giant altar pieces or church pieces. Telling some kind of story. This is a study. Study for the giant painting. The scale of this room. And these are large paintings too. Give you a guide for each wall so you could know what's going on. Quite a collection. Thank you. This is interesting because it's the first winterscape of European painting.